New people to crypto are expecting Bitcoin to moon. OGs in the space are telling everyone to calm down and wait for Bitcoin to plummet before making its great resurgence. The halving came and went without really giving us a strong indication of where Bitcoin is heading to. Is there a chance, though, that the noobs are right and Bitcoin could be getting ready for an upswing that is going to blow people's minds? This crazy bullish scenario is one that could take a lot of people by surprise. Find out why. Let's get it. Hello and welcome to BitBoy Crypto, your one-stop shop for all things related to Bitcoin and cryptocurrency. If this is your first time here, please make sure that you hit that subscribe button and turn on the bell for notifications so you never miss a video. To take the conversation even further, then please make sure to join one of my two Telegram groups, BitSquad for regular crypto chat or BitSquad Traders to discuss trading strategies. All right, guys, today we are going to be taking a look at the bullish case for Bitcoin. And at the end of the video, I'm going to be giving you two specific reasons why this cycle could be different and we may not experience panic selling like we have in the past. And of course, I'm referring to the short term here, like the next 2 months or so. Long term, we all expect Bitcoin to be at crazy numbers and to bust through all-time highs by the end of the year. But traditionally, what we have seen is a big dip after the last two halvenings. After the first halvening in November of 2012, BTC dipped 10% immediately following. However, it had a 30% drop in the weeks leading up to it. In 2016, the price of Bitcoin rose leading to the event, only to fall 30% 3 weeks later. But many people feel that a huge drop is coming in the next few weeks. The question is, why do they believe that? One event saw a 10% drop, the other saw a 30%. If we were to average those two together, we would get 20%. I know, I'm great at math. What is super interesting, though, is that we saw a 20% drop in the days leading up to this event. From May 8th to May 10th, the price plummeted from over 10K all the way down to 8K, which is, you guessed it, 20%. I believe there is a strong argument to be made here that the 20% dip we saw over those few days could have been the expected dip people were looking for after the event. But as you're probably familiar with, many people in crypto love to buy the rumor and sell the news. What this means is that anytime there is ever a big story in crypto, then you want to sell prior to the actual news announcement or event. This used to kind of be an untold secret that only the most experienced in crypto understood. However, now this is a common phrase people use. There are tons of news articles circulating about this technique. The point is that it is well known. Now think about it. What happens to a super secret strategy once the cat is out of the bag? Well, no longer works anymore. So people who decided that they were going to HODL until 24 hours or less before the halving got wrecked. Basically, the finish line moved. Instead of selling the day of the halving, many people sold a few days before, including whales. And this is what caused that giant dip. Now, a quick look at the daily chart shows that we are actually still in a buy trend according to the FOMO trender indicator on the daily chart. So while the price has gone down, the fact is we haven't broken through any major support that would put us on a downtrend. In fact, we've bounced hard twice. This really shows that in spite of Bitcoin dumping, the bulls are still relatively in control. So what kind of trend were we in during the last halving? Glad you asked. As we look here at the daily chart during July of 2016, you'll see we were actually in a sell trend that started 2 days before the event. The price wicked down, and the next day wicked down again. Kind of like what we just saw. Only this time, we saw it 4 days before the event instead of two. However, one major difference is that we never were in a buy trend in the days following the halving in 2016. It took us over 2 months to get back into a buy trend. It's different this time. Now listen, don't go pick out your Lambo color just yet. We can't be 100% certain what will happen. The charts have been teetering toward heading south, but the important thing is that they have not yet. People love to talk about how the halving is priced in before the event. This means that basically the speculation leading to the event causes the price to rise more than the event itself. But I believe this is a giant misconception about price action, production, and Bitcoin. In crypto, you have to look at all time frames. The longer the time frame, the more reliable the data is. When we zoom in and look at Bitcoin on smaller time frames, it is hard to see the effect of something like the halving. If we looked at the 5-minute chart for the 1 hour where the 630,000th block of Bitcoin was mined, it would seem rather uneventful, because it was. But when you zoom out, it is impossible to deny the effect that cutting the production of Bitcoin has on the price. There's no such thing as the halving being baked in. You can't cut production until the production is actually cut. Bitcoin is more rare today than it was yesterday, at least in terms of new Bitcoin coming into circulation. And that supply of Bitcoin is the quality that makes it better than any other asset, in my opinion. We talk a lot about the definition of the halving, or halving as many call it. The halving is an event that occurs approximately every 4 years when 210,000 Bitcoin blocks are mined. After every 210,000 blocks, the amount of rewards a miner earns for mining a block is reduced by 50%. It started out at 50 BTC, went to 25 after the first cycle, 12.5 after the second cycle, and starting yesterday, miners now earn 6.25 BTC per block. I believe a lot of people focus on these as rewards, which, yes, this is the amount of BTC that miners earn. But another way to say this is that now when miners produce a block, they are minting 6.25 new BTC to come into the total circulating supply. The focus, I believe, is too much on rewarding miners when we should really be looking at this in terms of the production of new Bitcoin. We have literally seen the amount of new BTC cut in half. So let's do a quick rundown of math. In the last cycle, there were 210,000 blocks. Miners brought 12.5 new BTC into the supply with every block. That means that between July 9th, 2016 and May 11th, 2020, there were 2,625,000 new BTC brought in. Over the next almost 4 years, that number will drop to 1,312,500 new BTC brought into the supply. Imagine if PlayStation or Xbox said, "You know what, guys? Every 4 years, we're going to make 50% less systems." Imagine the value those would have over time. When you cut production, prices rise. This is a universal truth. Bitcoin's price does not rise on pure speculation alone. Supply and demand economics are built into it. This is why the price of Bitcoin rises drastically over the halving events. And as long as people are interested in Bitcoin, it will continue to make it rise. The point here is, though, that the event itself does have a long-term effect on the price that cannot be priced in. But short term, we cannot calculate the effect the event has. But I'm starting to lean more into the camp that we may not see a huge dip. Of course, I already explained earlier that we just had a 20% drop. But the two main reasons why I believe this cycle could be different are the high volume numbers and the gigantic March crash. The volume for Bitcoin has been insane lately, especially compared to the last event. While miners certainly knew about the last halving, retail investors didn't really have a clue about it. This time, there is more education, so this was a highly anticipated event. When you look at the BTC volume over the last month, it has been very high. When coupled with Google Trends data, it stands to reason that much of this volume is made up of new people coming into the space. And guess what? New people do. They buy. They have no interest in selling and won't until the price reaches all-time highs again. Secondly, the March 12th crash of Bitcoin was an astounding 60% drop. We haven't seen anything like that since the earliest days of Bitcoin. That 60% number is double the largest drop Bitcoin had in the months leading up to or immediately following each of the last two halving events. While a cut in production cannot be priced in, I do believe it is possible that the 60% drop we experienced could have exhausted sellers, making the traditional halving drop baked in. But remember, no one can tell you exactly what will happen. Today, I've explained to you why I believe Bitcoin could avoid negative selling action. But that could change at the drop of a dime. Now it's your turn. Do you believe we are heading to much lower prices, or are we just going to keep on trucking? I would love to hear your thoughts, so please make sure to drop them down below. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then please make sure to smash the like button and hit subscribe to become a member of the fastest growing community in crypto, the Bit Squad. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. BitBoy out.